Well, hello there, Spider-Dash here.
If you're like me, you might be a big Spider-Man fan. And if you're even more like me, your favorite cartoon of all time is The Spectacular Spider-Man. And how it wouldn't be your favorite cartoon of all time? This cartoon has everything. Great characters, a great story, and a fair share of mysteries. That's why today I want to bring you The Spectacular Spider-Man Iceberg. I made this iceberg and I think that it turned out pretty well. So if you want to see it, I'll leave a link in the description. And only 20% of you guys are subscribed. So if you're enjoying my content, give me a like, click the subscribe button, and leave in the comments your favorite villain from the Spectacular Spider-Man cartoon. Thank you so much for watching, and with that out of the way, let's begin! Tier 1, Clear Skies. The Tinderbox. The Tinderbox is the band that composed the main theme of the show. All the members of the band are Mexican-American and grew up in Los Angeles. They met in high school and decided to form a band. Spider-Man Friend or Foe. Back in the day, it was really difficult to make your product known, because even if the internet existed, it wasn't as easy as nowadays to spread information. That's why sometimes the best strategy was to place ads of your products in other already existing products. That's why in the extras of Spider-Man Friend or Foe, there is a trailer for the Spectacular Spider-Man show. Many of us found about the show this way. Series cancellation. Spectacular Spider-Man was supposed to have at least 5 seasons, and it was cancelled because Disney bought the television rights of Spider-Man from Sony. Josh Keaton. Josh Keaton makes the voice of Spider-Man in, obviously, The Spectacular Spider-Man. But he is a fan favorite voice actor when it comes to the Spider-Man fandom, because he has been working on a lot of Spider-Man projects for a while now. He is the voice of Electro in Marvel's Spider-Man, made by Insomniac. He makes the voice of Ultimate Spider-Man in Spider-Man Shattered Dimensions. Also, he is the voice of Spider-Man in the video games Marvel vs. Capcom 3 and Marvel Super Hero Squad. So, if there is a Spider-Man project that requires voice acting, Josh Keaton is really likely to be around. Most Loved Adaptation. Spectacular Spider-Man is one of the Spider-Man's most loved adaptations. Many fans say that it is the best, or at the very least, the best Spider-Man cartoon. What did you think? Is this the best Spider-Man cartoon? Leave your opinions in the comment section. Tier 2, The Tip of the Iceberg. Physical releases. If you want to own the show physically, you are lucky, because it is possible to buy the show either in DVD or in Blu-ray. Personally, I recommend the Blu-ray version, because it already has all the episodes. Some of the DVD versions don't come complete, and you'll have to buy more than one DVD to have all the episodes of the show. Alex O'Hearn. In the show, Rhino's real name is Alex O'Hearn, but we all know that his real name in the comics is... But this is no mistake, because O'Hearn is an anagram of Rhino. Peter's Mole. One of the oddities about the show is Peter's mole. Why he has a mole under his left eye? Well, this is simple. Sean Holloway, character designer of the show, has a mole on the same place. That is the reason why he puts a mole under the left eye of some of his characters. Crossovers. Greg Wiseman, director of the show, said that he wanted Spectacular Spider-Man to meet another characters from the Marvel Universe, among them the Fantastic Four, and specifically the Human Torch, the X-Men, and Captain America. But obviously this never happened because of license issues. Amazing Fantasy number 15. The show makes multiple references to Amazing Fantasy number 15. One is on the intro, and another on the first episode. Also, the first episode is slightly inspired on The Amazing Spider-Man number 2. Secret Romance. On the 8th episode, named Reaction, Spider-Man saves a guy and a woman from a car accident. We can see that they fall in love with each other. Well, much more later, on the 23rd episode, named Gangland, we can see the same guy proposing the same woman. This is a really cute detail, to say the least. Meeting the love of your life because Spider-Man saved you both? That is goals. I don't want to meet the love of my life if it isn't because Spider-Man saved our lives. Wait, that will never happen. Not because Spider-Man doesn't exist, but because the love of my life doesn't. Tier 3. Below the Surface. Figures and collectibles. There are a lot of figures of the Spectacular Spider-Man, consisting of Spider-Man and his villains. All of them are really well made, and they respect the show's art style, which is nice. Although, if you happen to want one of them, be warned, it won't be cheap. Emily Osborne. Throughout various episodes, we can see Norman's wife and Harry's mom, a character named Emily Osborne. She never says a word, but it is confirmed that in the now cancelled 3rd season, we will have seen her take a more important role in the show. Spider-Man face background. All of the episodes of The Spectacular Spider-Man end with the Spider-Man face in the background. Well, this is a reference to the comics, when sometimes they will end this way. This started with The Amazing Spider-Man issue 10. The Enforcers. Speaking of The Amazing Spider-Man issue 10, this was the debut of The Enforcers, an obscure group of Spider-Man villains that appears in the comics here and there. They appear on the first episode of The Spectacular Spider-Man. Raimi's Spider-Man references. The Spectacular Spider-Man makes references to the Raimi trilogy in various scenes, but not only that, a lot of things in the plot are made to be the same of the Raimi trilogy plot. This was made so people that only watch the movie won't be confused by watching the cartoon. Real Kisses. Greg Wiseman said that every time that the characters of the shows that he directs kiss each other, the voice actors kiss in real life. Which means that the voice actors of Peter and Gwen and Peter and Liz Allen kissed in real life, while making the scenes of the show. Alana Ubak is the voice of Liz Allen, and Lacey Chabert is the voice of Gwen Stacy. Tier 4, the bottom of the iceberg. Cletus Kasady. On the 3rd episode of the 2nd season, or well, the 16th episode, named Reinforcement, we can see a cameo of Cletus Kasady, aka Carnage.
Encouraging news, Cletus, but it was Max's turn to speak.
Face it, Tiger. When Mary Jane Watson first appears in The Spectacular Spider-Man, on the 6th episode of the 1st season, her introduction is almost the same as in the comics. She first appeared in The Amazing Spider-Man issue 42. The Amazing Spider-Man issue 100. On the 12th episode of the 1st season, we can see a reference to the cover of The Amazing Spider-Man issue 100. iTunes. You can watch The Spectacular Spider-Man on iTunes, but the thing is that some of the descriptions of the episodes are wrong. It mentions that the Human Torch appears, as well as the Kingpin. McDonald's and Burger King collaborations. When The Spectacular Spider-Man was released, both Burger King and McDonald's made collaborations with The Spectacular Spider-Man. If you bought one of their Happy Meals around this time,
You could get a toy from the Spectacular Spider-Man. It was a nice time to be a kid. Gargoyles. Greg Wiseman said that one of the inspirations that he used to make the Spectacular Spider-Man was Gargoyles, a Disney Channel cartoon. He used it as inspiration to make some of the action scenes, as well as the Electro episode. For some reason, I think that it's worth mentioning that Greg Wiseman is the director of Gargoyles. Inspiration to make The Amazing Spider-Man. It seems that Mark Webb's The Amazing Spider-Man was inspired by The Spectacular Spider-Man, mostly because they share a lot of similarities. Among them, Gwen being the main love interest of Peter Parker, Oscorp making almost all of the villains, and Peter and Flash developing a closer relationship. Tier 5, Shallow Waters. Symbiotic Bonds Level. When Spider-Man gets the symbiote, the logos on his suit barely change, but through the episodes, both the logo on the back and the front get progressively bigger. This is because the symbiote is taking control of Peter Parker progressively as well. Unseen footage. The DVD and Blu-ray of The Spectacular Spider-Man were supposed to have deleted scenes of each episode and behind the scenes about how each episode was made, but in the end, this idea was cancelled. This unseen footage is somewhere in some Sony's drawer. Hong Kong action style. At first, Sony wasn't sure about making The Spectacular Spider-Man, but one of the ideas that convinced Sony to make the show was to make the action scenes similar to Hong Kong action movies, where the characters move really fast and they are really agile. Also, somewhere around here was born the art style, consisting in giving the characters really long limbs. Show's creators' cameos. The creators of the show have small cameos. Greg Wiseman, director of the show, and Victor Cook, supervising director, appear on the intro. And Shane Galloway, character designer, appears on the 7th episode of the first season, named Catalyst, as a DJ in the background. Stan Lee cameo. On the first episode of the second season, named Blueprints, Stan Lee has a cameo, and not only that, his character is even voiced by the man himself.
You know when you put your tongue on the side of the ship and it sticks there? I hate when I do that.
We miss you, Stan. Created by Stan Lee and Steve Ditko. The Spectacular Spider-Man was the first and only Spider-Man cartoon to give credit to both Stan Lee and Steve Ditko for the creation of Spider-Man. Gwen Stacy's dead. According to the show's creators, they never had plans of killing Gwen Stacy, although her and Peter wouldn't end up together. Peter's parents' picture. On the 13th episode of the first season, Nature vs. Nurture, we can see a picture of Peter's parents, which confirms that in this universe, Peter met his parents on his early childhood. Although, if his parents were secret agents is yet to be confirmed. Tier 6, Dark Waters. Scrapped movies. According to the show creators, they were working on animated movies of The Spectacular Spider-Man that were supposed to be released on DVD, but in the end, this was scrapped along with the third season. College arc. According to Greg Wiseman, from season 3 to season 5, we would have seen Peter going through his college years, but alas, this was cancelled. Peter and MJ's wedding. According to the show's creators, Spectacular Spider-Man would have ended with the wedding of Peter and MJ, which is sad to know, because we'll never see this. Beach episode. It is confirmed that one of the movies that was planned to release was a beach episode special, because you know, no good anime is complete without a beach episode. We don't know much, but maybe, because of the setting, the main villain was going to be Sandman. Scorpion. One of the villains that was supposed to appear on the third season is Scorpion, which would have been great to see him. Hobgoblin. Ned Leeds is on the show. It is confirmed that we will have seen him become the Hobgoblin. It was going to be just like in the comics. His relationship with Betty Brant was going to develop, and he will become the Hobgoblin later on. Clone Saga adaptation. Miles Warren appears in The Spectacular Spider-Man. He is the villain known as the Jackal. There are rumors that we will have seen an adaptation of the Clone Saga, somewhere along season 4 or 5. Same universe as Earth's Mightiest Heroes. Many people think that the Spider-Man that appears in some episodes of Avengers Earth's Mightiest Heroes is the Spectacular Spider-Man, although Greg Wiseman said that this wasn't true, and that they are not connected. Tier 7, The Abyss. Spider-Mobile. On the third season, we will have seen the Spider-Mobile. This would have been interesting. Sin Eater. The villain Sin Eater was supposed to appear at some point around season 3 to 5. It is unlikely that he will have anything to do with Venom, like in the comics. Mr. Negative. Mr. Negative's first apparition was on May 2007, and Spectacular Spider-Man's first episode was released on March 2008, meaning that both were created almost at the same time. Greg Wiseman had plans of using Mr. Negative as a villain in The Spectacular Spider-Man. Carnage. Cletus Kasady has a cameo on the show, but Carnage was supposed to appear on the third season. Peter and Flash box match. On the third season, we will have seen the box match between Peter and Flash, just like in the comics. This happens in The Amazing Spider-Man issue 8. Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. There are rumors that we could see the return of the Spectacular Spider-Man in the upcoming movie Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Josh Keaton tweeted this, and he said this on one stream.
Are you even allowed to say Spider-Verse? I'm allowed to say it. Yes, nobody is holding a gun to my head saying you cannot say it. But, you know, I can't confirm or deny anything about anything.
So, a return of the Spectacular Spider-Man is really likely. Venom spin-off. Along with the third season, a Venom spin-off was cancelled. It was supposed to show the origin of the symbiote, the planet Clintar, and more unoriginal adventures of Eddie Brock as Venom, but sadly, as I said, it was cancelled. Well, you stayed until the end. Thank you for watching this wait. Hello?
Hello, Spider Dash.
Oh shoot, it's the Rock from Jumanji. What's up, dude?
I think that you should give the people more.
More what? The iceberg is already over. I don't think that I can get more out of a cancelled show.
I said, you should give the people more. It's about drive, it's about power, we stay hungry, we devour.
Okay. Now get ready, because this is the real final iceberg. Now things are about to get crazy.
Did you just hang up on me?
Wait. It was not my intention, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, please forgive me! Guys, help! Ah! Tier 8, Purgatory. Episodes names, Unborked. On the first episode, we can see the names of the first three episodes on the board in the classroom. That is, Survival of the Fittest, Interactions, and Natural Selection. Almost no one noticed this. It's Itsy Bitsy Spider. Peter's ringtone on the show is the famous children's song, It's Itsy Bitsy Spider.
Oh man, where does the time go?
Gargoyles references. We already mentioned that Gargoyles was created by Greg Wiseman, so it is of no surprise that the Spectacular Spider-Man has a lot of references to that show, but it goes a bit further than that. Let me show you.
Terminus Benitez!
Oh, come on, what are you gonna do, bite my kneecaps off?
What are you going to do, bite my kneecaps off?
Ditko. On the sixth episode of the first season, when Spider-Man is running away from Tombstone, we can see a building with the name of Ditko. This is a reference to Spider-Man's co-creator, Steve Ditko. Black Cat foreshadowing. On the ninth episode of the first season, we can see that Black Cat appears during literally seconds. This happens one episode before her official introduction in the show. The Amazing Spider-Man issue 39. On the same previously mentioned episode, there's a scene where the Green Goblin is dragging Spider-Man with his glider. This is a reference to The Amazing Spider-Man issue 39. Secret Musician. On the sixth episode of the first season, we can see that Spider-Man saves a blind man. But in the previous episode, he's one of the musicians at the Tombstone's party. Man-Wolf. The ninth episode of the first season opens with this, which is a reference to Man-Wolf, one of the alter egos of John Jameson, who appears in the show as Colonel Jupiter. Harry Never Went to Europe. When Norman Osborn frames his son Harry of being the Green Goblin, he mentions that he is going to send Harry to Europe in order to get him some help. But a few episodes later, we can see that Harry still is in New York. For a few seconds, this was way before he was reintroduced in the show. So, there's a big chance that Norman was lying, and he had bigger plans. Maybe he was spying on Peter the whole time. We'll never know the truth. Tier 9. Hell. Romita's Pizza. On the 13th episode of the first season, Peter Parker mentions a place named Romita's Pizza.
I wonder if Romita's delivers turkey and fixin's pizza.
Which is a reference to John Romita, comic book artist and Mary Jane designer. The Godfather. The episode Gangland was inspired on the Godfather movies. Joker is Deathstroke. Young Justice was directed by Greg Wiseman as well, and it has some nods to the Spectacular Spider-Man, like this one.
Never did like to see a poor, dumb animal suffer.
No, I hate to see any poor animals suffer.
17. On the fourth episode of the second season, Peter's order number at the coffee shop is 117.
117!
Oh, that's us.
And Doc Ock hijacks a satellite with the name SSM-117. All of this happens on the overall episode number 17 of the show. So, there's a lot of 17 going around. If This Be My Destiny. In the same previously mentioned episode, there's a reference to the Spider-Man comic If This Be My Destiny, which is the issue 32, one of the best Spider-Man comics ever made. Hydro Man. In the same episode, again, we meet this guy, who we know is named Morris Bench.
Peter, this is Morris Bench, our demolitions expert.
In the comics, he's none other than Hydro Man. So, there's a really high chance that we will have seen him as Hydro Man in the now cancelled third season. Selina Kyle. On the 12th episode of the second season, Black Cat uses a fake ID with the name of Selina Drew. This is a reference to Catwoman's real name, Selina Kyle. And Drew is a reference to Jessica Drew, aka Spider-Woman. Spider-Man in Young Justice. As I previously mentioned, Young Justice was directed by Greg Wiseman, and he put a reference to the Spectacular Spider-Man, where Josh Keaton gets to reprise his role as a villainous version of Spider-Man.
You were warned, Mr. Jones. No one likes a crusading reporter. Ah, sorry. You know how it is. I'm on deadline.
Well, you stayed until the end, and wait, before you leave, I want to give a shout out to some of you. A shout out to Super Smash Legend Gaming, AP2, Rogers, Majora, Cashman Jedi, SMPS Gamer, TFA Studios, Tom Cruise, Team Drake, Mr. Zimbabwe, and last but not least, Eliaset Bassett. If you want to get a shoutout in my next video, give me a like, click the subscribe button, and leave in the comments your favorite villain from the Spectacular Spider-Man cartoon. And without anything else to say, I'll see you the next time.